sobra kong na-miss kayo. Well, sorry naman guys. Magpaka-busy rin kami sa pagpapaganda ng ating show. Para sure ball na sa ating muling pagkikita, wala tayong ibang dala kundi isang buong balikbayan box ng good vibes. So we better get going there and kung na-miss ko ng lahat na kagaya ko, kagaya mo, at kagaya ng nating lahat na merong
Wisdom na!
Here are our nightly inabangang Yak Bates. Tonight, let's invite our furry and furry side dahil ang ating pag-uusapan ang mga paboritong pussy cats ng ating favorite celebrities. Sino kaya silang just like me ay like na like ding mag-alaga ng mga kapo ni Hello Kitty? Well, here we go. First on our list ay ang kabogera kong kaibigan who, if you remember, ay siya ang first Pinay celebrity to reach 1 million followers on Twitter. Walang iba kundi si Ann Curtis na may alayang isang exotic short hair cat named Mogwai. Why oh why, I love to cuddle and pet Mogwai na napakakulit at napaka-fluffy din kahit pa short hair lang siya. Ang tabay!
Sir Tim, ako po, bakit hindi po niyo ako pinipet?
Because Rosa, you may be exotic and you may have short hair, but hindi ka naman cat, no? Nasaan sina Juanita and Pringles? Next up, we have the king of makeup transformation, si Paolo Ballesteros. When he's not busy transforming sa kung sino man ang mapagtripan itong si Pao, he's busy taking care of his 5 cats. Yes, ganun karami. Iba-iba man ang breed ng mga alaga niyang pusa na sina Gus, Beth, Bob, Jack, and Sam, same pa rin naman daw ang pagmamahal niya sa mga ito. Ibang klase ka talaga, Pao.
Huwag mo lang po silang gawin siya, Pao.
Next up, lahat tayo mai-inspire sa pet cat ni Barbie Forteza na pinangalanan niyang si Ben. Sobrang fan at crush na crush daw kasi ni Barbie si Dennis Trillo na kung maalala natin ay Be ni Tom Rodriguez sa groundbreaking 2013 drama na My Husband's Lover. Kaya naman para lagi na niyang kapiling si Be ay ginawa na niya itong pusa. Eh di ikaw na pala ang super fan ni Dennis, Barbie. Dahil dyan, bigyan ng cat food si Be. Ang napaganda naman si Heart Evangelista, busilak din talaga ang heart ni Heart in real life. Ang pet cat kasi niyang si Ming Ming, isang puspin o pusang Pinoy na ni-rescue niya sa Laguna. O diba, maging ang mga hayop sa kalye ay beneficiaries ng charity work ni Heart, who just, we just don't know yet, but can be a future First Lady of the Philippines. Pag ganun ba ang tawag kay Ming Ming, first pet?
Ay, makapag-apply na nga kay Ma'am Heart. Para balang araw, ako naman ang first yaya.
Hoy, Rosa, eh kung mga inuutos ko nga, di mo magawa, puro ka, time first. Lastly, we go international dahil ang susunod dating featured cat lover, isang Hollywood hitmaker at young millionaire. Yes, walang iba, kundi ang babaeng mahilig sa gitara at balahibo ng pusa, si Taylor Swift. Our friend Tay-Tay has 2 cats named Meredith and Olivia, both famous characters from American TV series. And when Meredith scratched her legs earlier this year, which resulted in a very long wound, Taylor kept her cool and joked that her cat owed her $40 million. Yun daw kasi ang value ng insurance niya for her legs.
Wow! I insure my legs too, but wala ako $40 million.
Okay, sige Rosa. Sagot ko na yung
$35 million?
Hindi, 35 scratches. Wait, go back. Kayo mga ka-good vibes, are you cat lovers too? Send nyo naman ang pic niyo with your cat tapos hang out sila with my cats, okay ba? Tweet me or tag me on Instagram at official Tim Yap. Tara, Yap next. Kung sabi nila ang cats ay rebels, ang ating next guests parang rebels din dahil pinaglaban nila ang sarili nilang brand of music. Kilala nyo natin kung sino sila. Well, Tim Yap, so return. Ikaw! We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Kenyak Show. We all know that in this industry and in this life, you need to be different for you to succeed. One of the standout finalists of Bet ng Bayan is here with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Kai Atienza. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Kai. Hello there.
Hi.
Hello. Oh. Please hop into bed.
Mwah.
How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
I love it that you're really different and you embrace that. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure it made the mark sa audience that you know that you are who you are. Kasi, diba, a lot of people, you know, they're shy or they choose to be you know, on the safe side, you know, as artists and as people, diba, it's, yeah. We should be able to express, not impress. And you've expressed yourself quite well just by from the way you look pa lang,
diba? Thank you.
What is your musical artistry? What is your journey? What has your journey been?
My journey, well, in this industry, to be honest, this was actually my first time to join a national television competition.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's a very, very nice experience because, you know, it's a different set of people, a different kind of audience, and you know, a different kind of music being presented to these people, and them liking it is just so surreal.
It's
just a very good feeling.
I love it that when they first saw you, did they tell you, oh, maybe you should try to look more normal or whatever, or did they tell you no, as you are?
I had both sides of the story.
Yes.
Yeah. Some would say na. Dapat yung hair mo, normal na lang, mas maganda ka siguro. Yes.
Sabi mo, itong normal para sa akin eh, bakit? Diba?
This is me. I like to explore things. I like to explore myself.
Yes.
Yeah, and other things as well. So I'm very, very comfortable and very, very happy that I'm like this right now.
I love it and I can totally see that. So you came from, you grew up in Australia?
No, actually, I grew up in the Philippines.
Okay.
I'm Filipina.
Okay. Where the meron kang accent na Australia?
Yeah.
Oh, where did that come from?
I stayed in Australia for a couple of years.
Mm.
My university.
Okay, okay. And was that where you found your music as well?
Yes, actually. Yes. Mm-hmm. Back when I was still here in the Philippines, I guess.
So marunong ako mag-Tagalog?
Opo, sobra.
Ayun naman pala eh. Oh.
Marunong ako mag-Tagalog pero medyo may twang lang.
Oh, oh, oh. Kasi ano, you think in English more, okay?
Yeah, so kapag tanungin mo ako in English as well, first thing na sasabihin ko rin, English din.
Oh, oh, oh. So yun nga, so you discovered your music in Australia, in university?
Yes, kasi iba yung crowd doon at iba yung type ng music. Na appreciate nila.
Oh.
So very, very versatile.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, mas may variety.
Yes, yeah, that's true.
How would you define your musical style?
I've always been asked that question, and up to now, I really, really can't give a straight answer.
It's still undefined.
Yes, but all I can say is that I play my music from my spirit.
It's a very spiritual way of expressing music.
Very personal, yes.
So you write your own songs too?
Yes, of course.
So it stems from your experiences. What is it? Heartbreak, family, loved ones. Where does it come from?
Everything. Life experiences. You know, can always write something about a cup of coffee. How it makes you feel good. How the kind of feeling, the kind of high that you get from that cup of coffee in your hand.
So it's a free flow thing.
Yeah, it's very, very free flow.
Okay, can we have a sample of your free flow?
Oh my god!
Yes, that's as free flow as free flow can be.
Can I do scat? Because I'm.
Go ahead.
I'm more comfortable doing like.
Yes.
With a ukulele?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Wow! So impressive and so relaxing and so much soul.
So you're right. It's undefined music.
Yes.
Yeah, but it really does come from your heart, from your spirit, from somewhere deep within, right? So how do you foster that spirit? I mean, you know, you are now based here, back in the Philippines, and so what keeps you busy? Are you making an album, a compilation of your artworks that to be shared by more, to be appreciated by more people?
Right now, I'm actually still working full time in an aquarium, Manila Ocean Park.
Oh, wow!
Yes, I'm a marine biologist.
You are a marine biologist working in Manila Ocean Park who plays the ukulele and scats. Okay, wow, but I'm sure that's not yet, it's not the definition yet because there's still so many dots to Kaya Tienza's artistry. Wow, what a study in contrast. What made you decide to take up marine biology?
Marine biology, because my family, we owned a fishery business back then.
Okay.
And I always loved listening to our people whenever they come back from the laut and then they share their stories about sharks and mga stingrays, mga pawikan.
Wow.
I've always loved listening to them.
So do you dive and you do? So you are a child of the water.
Yes. No, I am a child of the world.
A child of the world, yeah. That's true, that's true. So right now, your daily job makes you, you know, it makes you interact with people to appreciate the marine world even more.
Yes.
And what are the things that we need to know that we don't know, you know, that we don't know yet?
About...
I mean, in terms of marine conservation.
Marine conservation, well, there really are a lot. Like, you know, we have a lot of issues right now, like climate change and...
What is the closest to your heart?
Closest to my heart would probably be, of course, the ocean and preserving it. And, you know, the anthropogenic effects. Oh, my God, that's so high end of a term. But anthropogenic means that... humans,
mm-hmm.
like the activity that humans do, that all of us, everything that we do, it always impacts the environment.
As people think, oh, I'm only one human being.
Yes.
You know, but one human being impacts the world.
Yeah. And with 7 billion.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. What is in the works? What is in the near future for Kai?
I'm hoping that, you know, I'd have a lot of gigs. And this cafe in Eastwood recently opened, and I might be having gigs there as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Yuk Box Cafe.
Okay.
And they specialize in ukuleles. You can buy these ukuleles there.
Okay, well, great. Yeah. Okay.
These are actually handcrafted here in the Philippines.
Wow. I will go there and listen to you and buy one.
Thank you.
Ukulele for sure. Oh, thank you so much, Kai.
Thank you.
What
as well.
An enlightening, you know, short but sweet moment with you.
Thank you.
I look forward to experiencing more of your art.
Thank you, and I'd love to like chat with you again soon.
Yes, thank you so much. We have something for you from Rosa.
Oh,
from Cream
you.
Factory.
Thank
there you go.
Rosa.
Thank you so much. Wow, more to come. You know, more good vibes for a good night because we are here with Kaya Tienza. It's people like her, artists like her. That's why I love doing my job. What a great experience. What a great mm-hmm. discovery. Thank you so much. Okay, let's continue on with the music. Diba? Magbabalik po ang The Timmy Up Show in a bit.
Seems like everybody's got a price. I wanna have a sleep at night. When self comes first and the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious? Acting so damn mysterious. Got your shades on your eyes and your voice so high that you can't even have a good time. Everybody look to the left, yeah. Everybody look to the right. Can you feel the tip? Pain with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the cha-ching, cha-ching, ain't about the, yeah. The bling, the bling, wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag, yeah, yeah.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Team Lab Show. I have a little trivia about our guest for tonight. 15 years ago, we were together in the same studio having different points of view about something. Now, again, 15 years after, she is here and she is singing songs from her heart. Ladies and gentlemen, Kai Honasan.
Hi. Hello.
Hello there.
I'll just climb into bed here.
Yes. So what a great memory. 15 years ago, we were together on the same stage at a show called Points of View. Talking about, you know, you were talking about your childhood.
Yeah.
I was starting out in the industry.
Yeah.
I was like 3 years old.
We were both three years old.
We were both very, very young then. Mm-hmm. And it was like a debate. It was showing two sides of, you know, popularity. Mm-hmm. You know, I was in the party scene, starting out in the party scene, throwing parties, and you were talking about how it was being the child of a politician.
Yeah, I was there with my sister. She was doing most of the talking. I couldn't talk during that time. I was shy.
Okay, so from then on, so many things have happened in your life. You joined the reality singing show.
Yes.
And right now, where has life taken you?
Well, we're just finishing up the tour for the show. Mm-hmm. And then so I've been going nationwide promoting my songs. And then actually this weekend, I'll be leaving for New York and playing music there.
Wow, and are you gonna be based in New York?
No, just for a while, and then just to get the songs out and write a few more songs, and then come back here and kind of recharge and rebuild after like the
craziness. After the whirlwind of everything. Wow, did you expect that when you joined a singing show? Mm-hmm. Did you expect, was it all that and more that you expected?
No, not at all. I wasn't expecting to get in the show at all. I just wanted to do it for the experience. Mm-hmm. And then it turned into this massive thing that I can't even explain till now. It seems so surreal thinking about it. But it got my music out there, and that's what I wanted to do.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, and what is your music all about?
I always, when people ask me what the genre is, I always just say it's feel-good music. Mm-hmm. Because I play the ukulele. My voice is a little tiny. So, I mean, I'm not trying to say anything, a statement. I just want to entertain and just make people happy for three minutes.
How did you discover that that gift?
Making music?
Yes.
Well, I was singing in church choir, and then I tried to cover like Whitney and Mariah, and then I couldn't.
Wow.
So I guess,
singing contest.
Yeah, my voice can't handle that, so I decided to write my own songs that might fit my voice, and then I started writing.
The greatest love of all is not for everyone.
It's not.
Right?
Yeah, it's a good song, but it's not for everyone. So I decided to start writing my own songs. And then it snowballed from there, from high school. I did the whole band thing, and then college. I went to college for music, and then I taught preschool, and that's when I started playing the ukulele.
Wow, because you would play music for the kids.
Yeah, because they would get intimidated if we'd bring like a piano or a guitar. So I tried one time, okay, I'll bring a ukulele. And it was like I just strummed it once and I had everyone's attention. And the professors were like, that's never happened before.
And the kids paid attention.
Yeah, they were 2 to 5 year olds, like a group of 30. And you know how hard it is to get preschoolers together. And I strummed and then they listened and they kept listening.
And what was the first song you played for these 2 to 5 year old kids?
I was actually singing a song I wrote, which is, you know, for me, like, it's a love song, but then, I mean, I guess the melody appealed to them, so.
Wow, singing a love song for a 2 to 5 year old, but hey, they sat down and they took notice.
Yeah, they did.
Wow.
So that's my market.
Okay.
Preschoolers.
Oh, hello. That's a good market.
Because
when they grow up, they still have you with them.
Yeah, but I saw my former students and they don't remember me anymore.
They go, remember? Then Oh, it's you, Mr.
Also, I was like,
Honasan.
Much heavier then.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, so you know, I'd love to hear some music from you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Should I?
Yes, please.
Okay. Okay, this is a song I wrote because I wanted to get kilig over a boy. So I wrote my own pampakilig. So.
Wow, kinikilig ka na about the boy. Pinakilig mo pa yung sarili mo.
Yeah, because I wanted a song that would match the feelings I had, and I couldn't. I was sick of looping Britney Spears over and over again. So I wrote my own
song. Hit Me Baby One More Time kasi yun eh.
More of Sometimes.
Okay.
Yung ano, ballads. But this one is called Tongue Tied. And I'll sing you a bit of it.
Yes.
I could write 100 words for every second in this melody. Make a bunch of metaphors saying how it should be you and me.
But I can't and I shouldn't let myself live within this dream. While you're still living as somebody else's very special memory. But I can't stop myself every time I'm near you. I can't close the door to waste an opportunity to get to you. Cause all I do is get tongue-tied when I'm around you. I can't shut my mouth. All the words come tumbling out like pages of a diary that you just found. Lose common sense, cause all I do is get tongue-tied. There. That's a snippet.
Wow. So because of this song, the two-year-old sat down listening.
Yeah.
When you were singing it, I could like really see you with a guy closing the door and you know and everything.
Yeah, and I ended up making the guy listen to it and he didn't like it.
Ah, sabi niya, ah, this about me. Eh.
Yeah.
Feeling, ah.
Sobrang feeling. Oh. As in sabi niya, okay lang.
So dapat kinuha yung ukulele.
It's okay. You know, I went far naman. I don't know where he is.
That's the best revenge.
Yeah, success. Oh.
So aside from like love songs that make you kilig, mm-hmm. What are the other songs in your repertoire? What are the other songs that you've written about?
Well, I did something special with Ballet Philippines mm-hmm. last year because it was Andres Bonifacio's 150th. Death anniversary. So there was a play with Rock Ed, and then we wrote songs for it with Ebedencel, with Sandwich, Rico Blanco, all these guys. And then they realized in the play we don't have a girl, so they plucked me out of a bar, and they're like, "Can you write a song in a week?"
Grabe naman, we don't have a girl. Hey,
yeah, no, because the guys making it, they saw me play, and then they're like, "Can you write a song in a week about Andres Bonifacio?" And they sent me all these like historical facts and stuff. It's like, okay, I mean, this is a challenge. So I wrote about his. It's still a love song, but mm-hmm. it's from a historical point of view. How would you feel if your significant other was fighting in a war and you would never see him again? It's kind of hard to put yourself in that place, but I ended up writing a song about that. So.
Well, you can also, you know, X equals Y, you can use your father. You can write about
your
father.
Yeah, and right? Whenever I sing it, I'm like, I think my dad's the only guy who can actually relate to this song.
And has your father heard this song?
Yeah, he actually, he watched the premiere of the ballet and he cried.
Wow. Sabi niya, anak ako yung sinuot mo yung song, no?
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't understand how I came from him. Because I mean, he's a soldier. He's very, you know, uptight and, you know, very straight edge. Like
just here's somebody, her daughter, super expressive.
Yeah, and then you know, I'm just like, I can wear bright colors, and he hates that. But you know,
alam nga magkamo ka every day.
Yeah, I was like, do you want me to, you know, just wear black all the time? But you know, my neon shoes, they
love
freak
it.
Him out. Thank you, but they freak him out a bit. But I'm like, you have to accept. This is what he made.
This is a labor of love.
Yeah.
Exactly. Spreading more love. You know, you gospel of music to everybody.
Yeah, we just want to make people happy. That's it.
Great. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. I love your music.
Thank you.
Keep it up.
Thank you. It's nice to see you after so long.
I know, after 15 years. Mm-hmm. You still look the same.
We haven't aged.
Yes, exactly. Thank you so much. We have something for you.
Thank you.
Kai. And keep on pursuing your passion and making people more kilig with your music.
I will. Will do.
Yun, thank you so much, Marit Hotel Manila. And again, thank you so much, Kai. Keep on doing what you're doing. Nakaka-good vibes listening to her. Lagi yung sinasabi, dapat laging good vibes para laging good night. Kasama si Kai Honasan, who are watching The Tin Lap. Good night. We'll be right back.